parents, guardians. We all have people who raise us from helpless newborn to clueless young adult. I can almost guarantee, though, that your parents took different approaches to raising you. Perhaps your mom was the strict rule keeper, but your dad was more laid back and let you sneak cookies from the cookie jar before dinner. Either way, biologists have a term we use to describe these consistent and persistent approaches to parental care, and that is parenting style. Humans are not unique when it comes to the two-parent system. Biparental care is also necessary in songbirds like the Carolina chickadee because they too must raise helpless young, which is a time-consuming and energetically expensive endeavor. While chickadees can't make their chicks do chores or allow them to stay up late to watch TV, they do, however, have to feed them, keep them warm, and protect them from predators. Thus, to ensure chicks are adequately fed and protected, parents must cooperate. With that in mind, my research question is, do parenting styles in individuals affect how parents cooperate? And if so, do different modes of cooperation affect their fitness, meaning their ability to produce many high-quality offspring? I investigated these questions by measuring two parental behaviors: provisioning, by using spy cameras at the nest box, and nest defense, by presenting a fake predator, such as the snake, for the chickadees to respond to. I determined that chickadees have parenting styles by measuring how individuals divided up their effort towards provisioning versus defense. In this graph, I have defense on the x-axis and provisioning on the y-axis. Each dot represents an individual. I found that individuals who defend more also provision more. Therefore, individual chickadees are either high, medium, or low contributors. So individual parents do have styles, but do those styles matter when it comes to the parents cooperating to raise their young? I address the question of cooperation and styles by scoring how similar parenting styles are to each other. A score close to zero indicates high levels of similarity, or two parents that contribute equally towards tasks. A score that is highly negative means dissimilar styles, with the male being the higher contributor, and a score that is highly positive means dissimilar styles, with the female being the higher contributor. I then graph these scores against chick quality, which is one of my measurements of fitness. So far, I have found that parenting styles that are highly similar do create good quality chicks, but it matters that the male is the higher contributor, as you can see here. In conclusion, I have determined that parenting styles do create variation in cooperation between parents, and the degree of similarity does affect the quality of their chicks. So parenting styles do matter. Thank you.